Now, don't speak anything, okay? So our next topic is safeguard user privacy. Now, if we want that our information and our data should be kept private, should be kept safe, for that we have to take certain precautions. Rian, the seller must clearly state how the user data will be used. If seller has information about the buyer, one who is purchasing the product online, it is the responsibility of the seller to clearly disclose that in which respect the information of the buyer will be used. Okay? Then both seller and buyer must go through the terms and conditions specified in the contract. जैसे आप कोई ऐप डाउनलोड करते हो मोबाइल से, तो द इनिशियल स्टेप ऑफ एवरी ऐप इज यू रिसीव सर्टन टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस. दिव्यांश, यू रिसीव सर्टन टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस, बट समटाइम्स अनोइंगली वी क्लिक ऑन आई एग्री बटन, इग्नोरिंग द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस, एंड लेटर ऑन वी मे फेस सम प्रॉब्लम. Before clicking on I agree button, we must read all the terms and conditions that are specified in that app before downloading that app. Similarly, e-commerce transaction mein, both seller and buyer must be careful about all the terms and conditions that are specified in the transaction. Clear? Now, the next topic is fraud. This was the question of case study in the last year pre-board. This topic came as case study in the previous year pre-boards. Now, anything, any wrong thing occurring online, any fraud occurring online, that is called online fraud. Online fraud is in four forms. First is non-delivery of goods. I request everyone to carefully view the PPT. Instead, you are accessing your personal computers. Non-delivery of goods, non-existent companies, stealing information and fraudulent payments. You have booked the product, you make the online payment, but on the due date, you fail to get delivery of goods. Okay, that is one kind of fraud. Second is you enter into the transaction by putting your information in the website, but the website was a fake website that resembles the original, but it was not original. Stealing information, your personal information, your ID, your debit card number, your credit card number, they get misused. Okay. Fraudulent payments. Your payment criteria has been misused. Okay. So all these four forms are covered under the category of online fraud. Agar main first two frauds ki baat karu, non-delivery of goods and non-existent companies. These two losses can be compensated when we will put our problem in front of official bodies. There are some government bodies which are involved handling the cyber crime. If we will address our problem to them, definitely our problem will get solved in the case of first two frauds. The fraud number third and fourth, they are more dangerous. Because in these two type of frauds, two things are happening. One, our debit card, our credit card, our passwords, all our private information is being misused. They may be hacked by the hacker. Right? Secondly, it can affect our payment structure. Right? Then, our personal information, our identity can be stolen. That is called identity theft, where our personal information, complete data about us can be misused. Clear? How you can prevent the fraud? There are four ways, four security measures by which you can prevent the occurrence of online fraud. First, monitoring official body. Right? Just I told you, we can address our problem to the cyber police. We can file a complaint. We can file an EFIR against our problem. Okay? Next is strong security mechanism. These days, you might have seen when you are assessing your WhatsApp via computer or via laptop, you receive a security check. Jaise aapne apne smartphone mein pin lagaya hua, password lagaya hua, and you are assessing your, you want to assess your WhatsApp from your smartphone to computer. Aapne computer mein WhatsApp app web on kiya, aap apna WhatsApp PC pe kholna chahte ho, to sabse pehle jo smartphone pe password lagaya hai, wo password aapko enter karna padega computer pe. When you will enter the password, then only you will be able to access your WhatsApp on the computer. When you are making any payment online, aapne koi purchasing kiya online, you will receive OTP at your registered mobile number. Like suppose aap mein se koi students competition exams ke liye pair hote hain, so you file your data, you fill the digital form and you enter the information. They send you one OTP on the number that you have given it. When you receive the OTP and you fill the valid OTP again, then only you are able to execute further transactions. So all these techniques are to raise the security level, to provide satisfaction to the user that if he is entering into a transaction, his payment, his information will be completely kept secure. Okay? Nothing will get misused. Okay? Then, strong, secure payment methods. One thing is HTTP. One is HTTPS. What is the difference? S is secure. We are in the secure connection. And if we are assessing the website using HTTP, we are not under secure connection. Okay? And most of time, it is recommended that always do browsing in the incognito mode. When you open your Google Chrome, at the top side, you see three dots in the vertical position. Click on those dots and there is one option, incognito browsing. You click on that and you enter into the browsing in the incognito mode. Whenever you do browsing in that mode, history will never be created. Aap normal browsing karo, aapki history create hoti hai. Us browsing mein aapki history create nahi hogi. Aapke IP address ki information third party ko nahi jayegi. You are completely secure. Okay? Now, ensure safe sites while entering the crucial information. Whenever you are to enter your personal information, always prefer to do private browsing so that your information is not misused. First, type URL of the website in the address bar of the browser on your own. Do not click on any such link. Always type the complete URL in the address bar. Do not enter the website by clicking on the link given by someone else. Aapko kisi link bheja WhatsApp pe ki is link pe click karo to ye site khul jayegi. Never click on such unknown links. Okay? Ensure that address contains a padlock sign and HTTPS means the secure environment. Your connection is secure. Now read this red note carefully. HTTPS in a URL means it is a secure connection and no one can see your personal information. I told you information about your location, about your IP address will not be revealed to the third party. Okay? If you view the sample paper given by CBSE in the previous term, this was the case study given by them. Secure data transmission. Almost all terms, they have same meaning in one way or the other. Now, by name, it is very much clear. Secure data transmission. Your data should travel safely from one point to other point. Okay. In WhatsApp, generally this message comes, end-to-end encryption is there. Chatting in this window is end-to-end encrypted. And, I want to ask one question. In general sense, in simple meaning, what do you mean by encryption? Raise your hand. What you mean by encryption? Yes, Daksh. Safe, okay, indirectly we can say, yes, Saksham Grover. Yes, the correct answer is your original message gets converted into some code. Only the sender and the buyer, the sender and the receiver of the information, they know about that code. They know the criteria to break the code. If any third person will try to enter into the information, try to hack the information, he won't be able to get the code and your data remains secure. So we are to apply all the precautions. We are to take all the necessary steps so that our data travels safely from sender to the receiver, and our data should not be interpreted. Our data should not be compromised in between. Okay, how we can implement secure data transmission by applying these techniques? SSL, secure data transmission. SSL stands for secure socket layer. There are encrypted softwares available, LastPass, semantic end encryption, you can use them. SSL stands for secure socket layer. Now, what is this secure socket layer? Whenever server and browser, they are to build a connection, an encrypted connection is created. A secure connection is created by using the secure socket layer so that whatever communication arises between browser and server, the communication is completely secure. Clear? Then data encryption. Encryption, I just told you, converting your data in coded form. Okay? Converting your data into coded form. Right? Use safe protocols. Whenever you transfer information, we are always to use the safe protocols so that our information never get misused or never get hacked. Then comes the next concept, IPR, intellectual property right. Okay. Now, what actually IPR is? Okay. Before I proceed further, let me ask the questions. Let me ask how much you are aware of. Okay. Just raise your hand, whether online, whether offline. Full form of SSL. Only raise your hand. No random speaking I want in the lecture. Yes, Princey. Secure socket layer. Okay. Any fraud occurring on internet is called DASH. Vivan. Name any two forms of online fraud. Any two forms of online fraud. Riyan, you are not at all serious in the offline classes. And shortly, I'll be discussing the matter with your parents. Mind it. 5 warnings have been given to you. This is 6th warning. Yes, Tanya.
You are a system company and sharing of information.
Sharing of information, beta. Non-delivery of goods. non-existent companies, fraudulent payments, okay, stealing information, right? Okay. One technical difference between HTTP and HTTPS. Yes, Daksh. Okay. What is privacy? In general meaning, simple language, how you can define privacy? Yes, Bisham. Unmute yourself and tell me.
Privacy means like the information of the user remain private and it doesn't get in the hands of others.
Very right. Very right. All right. What is secure data transmission? What is secure data transmission? Data is not compromised. Data safely travels from server to from sender to receiver. Okay. Now comes IPR, intellectual property right. Any person who create any information is the owner of that information. You agreed? Agar ek person ne essay likha khud, to wo us essay ka sole owner hai. Okay? Just excuse me, online class. So I was telling you, if anybody has created the information, he or she is the sole owner of that information. Agar maine ek paper publish kiya, maine likha, maine publish kiya, to main iska sole owner hu. Now it is up to me how much information regarding my personal work I want to share with you people. To what extent I want to share my personal information, my created information with you people. And if I'm sharing, I'm giving you this privilege, will I be charging something or not? Clear? This is IPR. The rights of the owner of the information to decide how much information is to be exchanged with others. Like I have this information, how much information I will be sharing with you all. Okay. And since I am the owner, I have right over my information. I have the legal rights. I will decide that whether I'll be charging the price for sharing or not. And the rights which has been given to me are the legal rights. And how I can protect my rights, how I can protect my IPR rights in three ways. Patent, copyright and trademark. आप किसी particular brand के shoes purchase करते हो, उस company का एक अपना individual logo होता है, registered symbol, which is being marked on that product. जैसे Apple के phone के पीछे Apple का symbol बना होता है. Means that Apple logo is the sole logo, registered symbol of that very company. Apple has all legal rights over it. Okay. Second is patent. Patent ka general meaning samajh lo. Patents are always given on some invention work. Agar koi invention hui hai, उसके ऊपर जो राइट्स मिलते हैं बाय द लॉ दैट इज कॉल्ड पेटेंट. It is the right granted by the government to the inventor, giving owner. Owner means the creator of that product. The exclusive right for making, using, and selling of the product, selling of the invention. Hamesha yaad rakhna, patent is always on the invented work. Copyright is always on the artistic or literary work. I told you on that day one example about the problem which occurs with me. I didn't post the video on the YouTube. I downloaded one file from the internet. I delivered lecture using that very file. Later on, the downloaded file from internet, I try to upload on YouTube. I received the copyrighted message because that file which I download, it was having copyright issue. The owner of that information, they can file a copyright claim. So copyright is always on the artistic and any literary work created by you people. Patent is always on the invention. What is copyright? It gives the creator of the original work exclusive rights for a limited time. And on which type of work? On creative, intellectual, and artistic work. Dono mein rights available hai. Patent may be, copyright may be. But the difference is, patent is on any invention. Aapne koi machine banai, usko patent karwa liya. Aapne koi book likhi, uspe copyright ho gaya. Clear? The difference between the copyright and patent. Not trademark. As I told you, registered symbol, rhythm. Better what you are doing. What happened? Are you okay? Comfortable? Any registered sign, any design or expression which distinguish one product from the other. Nokia ka apna symbol hai. Apple का अपना सिंबल है, Vivo का अपना सिंबल है, Oppo का अपना अलग सिंबल है. These symbols, they help to differentiate one product from the another. You can recognize that yes, this brand is of Adidas, this brand is of Apple, this brand is of Vivo, and so on. This LED is of Samsung, this is of LG. हर कंपनी का अपना एक अलग लोगो है. जैसे स्कूल्स है, हमारे स्कूल का अलग लोगो है, एमजीएन का अलग लोगो है, एपीजे का अलग लोगो है. विद दैट यू कैन डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन इंस्टीट्यूशंस. ओके, नाउ द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस, सम रीजंस व्हाई आईपीआर मस्ट बी प्रोटेक्टेड. ओके, आईपीआर इज इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स. ओके, क्विक रिविजन, देन वील बी डिस्पर्सिंग फास्ट. Three ways to protect IPR. Trademark, patent, copyright. Trademark, patent, copyright. Which rights are for the invented work? For artistic and literary work? Encourage the individuals and businessmen to create new software and its application as well as improving the existing application. First thing is, they should create new applications. Second is, if they already have some application, they should redesign it, remodify it. Aap log dekhte ho, you download one app. After a few days, you get the message to update the app. Why updation occurs? Why there is need to update the app? Place to bring the recent changes in that. Recent files ko incorporate karne ke liye. Ho sakta usme koi naye features aa gaye ho. Theek hai? Jaise WhatsApp shuru mein kitna simple tha. Slow and steady, as we get on to update it, we get the calling feature, we get the payment feature also in WhatsApp. Right? Ensure new ideas and technologies which can be widely distributed. Day by day, customer ke changes hai. Customer ke taste badal rahe. If you are purchasing one brand of mobile today, after a few days, its value decreases. People want to have some other brand now. Okay. So as per the taste of the consumer, the company should redesign its product. Promotes investment in the national economy. Our national economy should rise. Right? I drop the lecture over here. We'll continue in the next class. Okay.